it's just
starting to sink in with me that I don't need to run through the places so fast and not just run through and see everything at once. I live so close here, I can be here often I want, so I'm going to make these Laura Park videos completely different from now on. I'm going to make them about one or two species at a time, tell and talk something about them, so not just running around anymore. I think I'm going to talk about these Pesquet parrots, Dracula parrots today, and maybe some macaws. Hello again. I think he has started to recognize me. He flies to the net when he saw me. I've been visiting him multiple times already. Don't worry. I'm going to talk a little bit more about Pesquet parrots. Well, I don't know much about them, but what I'm going to tell what I know. For the starters, here at Laura Park there is four Pesquet parrots. This, the friendly male, you can tell the male by the red spot behind the eye. Girls don't have it, they are black. And there's two more, and on the up there's one more, and they are living here with small lorikeets. Pesquet parrots are naturally from New Guinea, so the these lorikeets are from same area, you could say. And here is Irish lorikeets, Goldias lorikeets, and then Pesquet parrots. And they have a similar kind of diet. They eat nectar and fruits mainly, so no seeds or pellets or anything like that. That's why they are kept together here, because they eat the same food and they are from the same area naturally. Their enclosure is really nice. I would say it's something like maybe 15 by 15 meters, and it's round, so you do the math. The radius of the circle is something like 7.5 meters, so it's quite big. And they have this nice tree there. And they seem really happy, as all birds do here in Laura Park. Pesquet parrots, also known as Dracula parrot or Vulture parrot, because of their their look, the long slender beak and the head shape, but they don't eat meat or anything like that. They are just friendly herbivores. He really likes to nibble my finger. He doesn't bite at all. I visit this guy every time I go to the Laura Park, and that's almost daily. I have a free access here, and I live 15 to 20 minutes away from here. and I need to visit Santa Cruz, Puerto Santa Cruz City really often, so I'll visit here multiple times per week, and I don't think I'll get bored ever. But yeah, if you visit Tenerife, you can meet friendly Pesquet parrot here. And if you visit Tenerife anytime, you can always call me. I can show you around and tell more things, whatever you want to know about this place, Flora Park or Tenerife. And yeah, I don't know much about Tenerife yet, but most likely I know more than a first visiting tourist. Where to shop, where to go to bar, etc. I videoed them before too, but here they are now closer. The Hyacinth Macaw and his, I think, Buffon's Macaw friend. He is too big to be military Macaw. Buffon Macaw, also known as the Great Green Macaw.
So happy that we met your criteria.
The buffoons are really interested about us humans watching him. They seem to be a bonded pair. But this is how it goes in captivity. Even if they have same species friends, they might pick up some different species easily. Yep, they are a bonded pair for sure.
Hello!
Here is one green-winged Macaw. He usually have a friend here with him too. And I've been told they are usually in a bigger enclosement too, but they are part of the loro show here. So that's why they are today here. And they only use one of them at a time on the show. The other one is waiting here. Are you a nice guy? Or a bitey guy? Nice guy or bitey guy? Bah! Okay, you're a nice guy. Or a girl. Okay. Green-winged macaws are kind of gently giants too. They are really big. Big species of macaws, almost the size of hyacinth macaws, and they can eat macadamia nuts in a cell too. There is only three parrots that can do it: green-winged, hyacinth, and a palm cockatoo. That's why when people get a hyacinth macaw, they usually can't afford another one. But if they want him to have a friend, as they should want, they usually get a green-winged because they are same kind of personality. They usually get along really, really good. Yeah, he's a really, really friendly guy. Here is another loro show star. So it's just a typical blue and gold macaw. Yeah, the most common pet macaws you see around Yeah, usually not that kind of personalities as hyacinth macaws or green wings, but they are quite easy birds usually. Not like scarlet macaws and military macaws, etc., who can be kind of nippy. Red fronted macaws, these you don't see every day. One of them says hello, I don't know which one it is, but I think they want us to scream now. It's only like... Okay, here it says it. Only 1 to 4,000 in wild. They're one of the species Laura Parkway is breeding and releasing to the wild. To the programs worldwide. Green wings, scarlet macaws, military macaws, buffon's macaws, hyacinth macaw, and I think there's one Lear's macaw somewhere too, but he might not be there. Oh, and I see there's something else than parrots here too. Yeah, I don't know what he is, but here he is living with the parrots. I'm sure there's two of these. The other one is completely black. Maybe that's the male or female. I saw it on my last visit, but I really didn't think it was a real one because it didn't move at all. Here I'm driving home again, and thank you guys again for watching my video. And I'm going to repeat myself like I do in every video. If you like my content, please subscribe. We are on super tight budget, and we need funding to get our parrot rescue operation running here on Tenerife. Subscribing helps us, and if you want to chip in more, check our Patreon and merch store links on video description. All the money we get through them will go towards the aviariums and will not be used on anything else. Thank you guys, and see you again tomorrow.